Hey guys, what's up? This is Nayan here from Barrack Solutions, and today we will talk about the Ubuntu operating system interface. On your screen is the Ubuntu Graphical User Interface. Ubuntu is built on the Debian Linux project, and it is maintained by Canonical Ltd, which is a company based in United Kingdom. Ubuntu is the most widely used Linux operating system, and the Graphical User Interface says it all. Apart from the Graphical User Interface, Ubuntu has also managed to add features which Windows and Mac users enjoy, and thus it has created a new operating system for users who can enjoy features of both Mac OS X and Windows. If we have a look at the interface, on the left hand side we have the dock, and on the top, that's this gray color bar, is nothing but the status bar. The status bar provides us with the application options like file, edit, view, go, help, etc. And it also gives the status of other hardware components of our machine, like whether the Bluetooth is on or not, whether my internet is connected, my sound, my time, and also my settings, where I can log out, suspend, restart, shut down, or even change the user. So that's really nice. If you have a look at the dock can be easily tweaked to your liking. Like you can add an application to your dock, or remove an application from your dock, or even change the visibility of your dock. It's dock. If you have a look at the dock more closely, you have something known as the Workspace Switcher. If you click on it, you have four workspaces, and these are separate desktops. For example, if I have an application, let's say I have a home folder opened on this particular workspace, that is the first workspace, and let's say I switch to my other workspace. So, you know, it helps you in multitasking. The workspace is exactly as the desktop, adding desktop feature on the Mac OS X. In Mac OS X, you have mission control to add multiple desktop. In Ubuntu, you call it as the workspace switcher. So it's just the naming difference, but they both are the same features. So that's really nice. And it's awesome to use multiple applications because it becomes easier for the user. If you want to remove an application from the dock, you can just right click on it and select unlock from launcher. One more awesome feature of this dock is that it can go down as long as possible. The list just goes down and you can just keep on scrolling down. You have the system settings in here, and for the Mac users, you will be like, oh yeah, it is similar to the Mac, because the Mac system preferences is exactly as the system settings of Ubuntu. So Ubuntu has tried to bring Windows and Mac OS X features, as I told you earlier. And we have the dash home, which is one of the key features of Ubuntu. And that's pretty much because you can access anything from this particular dash home. It is like the spotlight of Mac. You just type in, let's say I just type in Firefox, and I get it. And it's really very fast. It's not like Windows. It's just like Mac OS X Spotlight, which is quick to respond. And that's really nice. And you can even search the applications or files by categories, whether it is books, or whether it is a document, whether it's a photo, whether it's media or something of that sort. And we have the Ubuntu Software Center, from where users can download their latest applications and updates. Users can also make use of terminal to download the applications. And we have the software updater, which will keep on popping up every time you have a software update. You can even disable these features. And that's pretty much the Ubuntu operating system. And that's it with this video, guys. I hope you liked it. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and visit techbarrack.com.